got to, like, make time to hang out with people.
Let me tell you something. I hate driving into New York City.
Yeah.
I don't drive it either.
No, I wouldn't. That's one of the reasons why, like, I set up out here, is that I knew there's a lot of people I can hang out with.
It's brutal.
Yeah. That hour is a lot. When I went to visit you, when we were in the city for the UFC, and then I came out to visit you, that was a long-ass drive. And then we went to play pool down in, what was that town? It's like a couple
Edison.
Towns. Yeah, a couple towns over from you.
And fucking Edison got some good place to eat, too. Though.
Yeah?
They took me to a place there. My neighbors, you know, again, I was just happy to be around Italians again. You don't understand. I feel a lot more comfortable around Italians, a couple Irish, a couple brothers. I'm good. Maybe a Chinese family.
I just think you didn't want to be around Hollywood anymore. I don't think it has to do with nationalities.
No, it was LA. I'm just joking around.
I know, but you were always a guy, like, before all of us, that was sick of, like, that system, the Hollywood system. You were always making fun of the agents that would come around that would promise you the moon, and all these executives, and all these people that would come around and watch shows, and hee-hee, and ha-ha. You hated all that shit. You always hated all that shit.
You know what, man? It was good for a period of time, and then we all figured out what we were going to become. You know, once you realize the direction you want to take this, and you were the leader of that, like people going, I don't want to act anymore. I don't want to play the piano no more. This is what I want to do. I want to do a stand-up. I loved what happened. Listen, man, I was locked up, and next thing you know, I'm at the fucking Comedy Store. You know what that feels like? You know?
I know.
Being there with, crazy, you know, fucking Bill Burr and Brian and all these people, so... After a while, it just got fucking old. It just got really old. To be honest with you, the main thing that I want to get out, I had too much of a comfort level.
Too comfortable just showing up there and doing sets?
Just too comfortable. It was too comfortable my whole life. My whole life revolved around a 4-block area. You know, my house, the office, jiu-jitsu, cryotherapy, the weed store.
Don't you think that just any kind of change like that is always good?
Yes. Yes. It was time. It was 23 years.
Yeah.
23 years there, 2.5 in Seattle, 13 in Colorado, you know, 1.5 years locked up. It was time.
Yeah.
It was time to come home. It really was time. I didn't do it for any, just wanted to go home. I wanted my daughter to fucking see the things I saw as a kid, not North Jersey type shit.
Mm-hmm.
But I want to, did you see that fucking special on that amusement park when we were kids from Verona,
no,
New Jersey? What's the name of it? Action Park.
No.
They ended up calling it Class Action Park.
That's terrible.
Dog, you
what
gotta
happened?
Watch
What
this.
Happened? Was it
That's
accidents?
Where we used to go when we were kids. Yeah, every time you went there, they take you out of a neck brace. Fuck it when you were a kid, Doug. Please, Jamie, if you find anything, a trailer.
Dude, I was at a fucking one of those fairs that they would pull up in a parking lot.
Look at this shit. When we were kids, you know.
Jesus Christ, you're flying down these things. How many kids got broken legs from
this? Oh, my God. Every time you went there, if you went with 8 kids, somebody was going down.
The most dangerous amusement park.
And in Vernon, New Jersey or Vernon, New York. Look at
it. Oh, my God. People are jumping off cliffs. Whoa. You could drive race cars?
Everything.
What is this, bungee jumping?
This was the 70s with the Class Action pool. That was like Palisade Amusement Park. It's a pool that's like a big cops probe. Look at this shit. Look.
Park accident. So people just got in accidents all the time.
Oh, every other weekend. Look at it.
But is that okay?
Yes.
Here's the question.
When I was a kid, I didn't go out to play. I went out to die. Big difference, okay? These little fucking half of fruitcakes today, they go out to play. I went out to die. Remember you hugged your mother and shit? Like, you hugged the good. Ma, I don't know. We're going to go rob a train. I don't know what's going to happen. But look
shit,
at this shit.
This shit is so ridiculous.
And New York had a ton of these when we were kids. From Tuxedo, New York, all the way down.
Oh, my God. That's hilarious. Action Park.
You got to watch the doc. Why was this allowed to happen?
So here's the question. If you could go, like, if you, guys are doing, like, BMX flips, you know, guys are practicing for those things, how many of those guys get hurt? A lot, right? How often do they get hurt? Well, why is it okay if they get hurt, but it's not okay if you go to a park where you're reasonably certain you have a good chance of getting hurt? Like, if if it's basically people paying to have the same kind of risk factor as you would do if you were doing something else crazy. That's totally okay. Like, why can't you? You know what I'm saying? Like, you can get a BMX bike. There can be a ramp. People know you're gonna jump it. Everybody knows. That's fine. But that, what is that, more of a commitment? Because you went, you got a helmet, you got a bike, and you got the whole thing, instead of just going to this place. This should be a place where it's fucking risky, right? This should be a, like, if somebody had, if you had a locked down solid contract where no matter what happened to you, you couldn't sue them, they can make a place like that again. But I don't think they would ever be able to hold one of those contracts in court.
You gotta watch the documentary. It's tough. I remember watching.
Oh,
yeah,
it's
yeah.
tremendous.
But is it negligence?
Yes.
Oh, okay.
If I remember correctly, there's a lot of people telling them you can't do this for kids, and people are like, "Give a fuck! It's the '80s. We're doing coke. We're making money. Have fun."
But
party.
The jumping off cliffs, like that thing, like the fact that they had a cliff dive, like that's just crazy. Dumb. They built a cliff dive, and people could just jump. Like if you hit. If you're jumping off of,
yeah, this is the big thing that they had there, remember? The bridge where everybody would, like, get drunk and jump off of, and people were getting hurt. They're landing on each other all the time.
Oh, of course. Look at that. I can imagine that they would. I imagine people landing on each other on purpose.
I think that's part of it, because they would cheer. It'd be like, yeah. you're the man for the 5 minutes of the summer day.
That's a great way to break your neck. Someone flying and landing on you, that is a great way to break your neck.
It's really good. I think there's even a fictionalized version that Johnny Knoxville made that really popped up in that thing. And I don't remember that.
You know, these places, it was the 70s, mm-hmm. late 70s, early 80s, 70s. I don't think the insurance regulations are as strict as they are today. Like, they didn't have a fucking idea. Open up a park, yeah, whatever, just give me $900 a month. Send us a check on the first.
They probably didn't have the kind
of
lawsuits.
They don't know. What kind of place is this? It's like Seaside. You know, it's nice. Couple little swings and shit.
Here's a question. When did the first lawsuits emerge? Like the first law, like a civil lawsuit, like someone suing you because they did a thing and they got hurt. And like you were, like you get trampled at the circus or something like that. Like when?
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. the season. On Wednesday, Kawhi Leonard made his return, and it was felt. Kawhi helped stage a double-digit comeback as the Clippers upended the Pistons. Now they turn their attention to the Spurs and Keldon Johnson. The Spurs got off to a nice start but have cooled since the Clippers beat them 2 weeks ago. But they have shown the ability that they can get hot.
You see them trying to corral Paul George as he pushes the ball in transition.
George, long two, knocks it down.
Who's listening? They've won two games while holding opponents. That means the defense must be doing pretty well.
I'm going to restate it. Many for the Clippers have not been. Leonard into traffic, makes a nice pass. Good ball movement for the Clippers. Morris for three, it's good. Nice screen from Zoo. Brings Poeltl out on the wing with him with 10 to shoot. George, rhythmic three after a nice pass from Leonard. It's
defensive player lost sight of him, and that's how Kawhi was able to hit him with that pass.
Pocket pass into Poeltl to the rim again.
And actually going up and blocking the shot directly.
Zoo in space finds an open Paul George in the corner. Rainbow three. And Antonio, it is Clipper basketball, seven to shoot. Inbound goes to Morris. Gets right to the rim. Vicious. 25 is the limit. That's what we're going off of on that last game. And the best part about it is Batum gets a clean look from three and knocks it down. Not a gifted three-point shooter, just 6 of 35 coming into the game here tonight. Wall. Nice pass in the corner to Jackson. A rope scraping.
So they're playing basically with a lot of wings out there. You've all got to go in and grab your share of defensive rebounds.
Ninth time the Spurs have trailed by home this season. Cuts the lead down to 7. Wall orchestrating the lob to Jackson, makes the grab, draws the contact. Oh, what a save there by Batum. And now the Clippers look to push. Wall behind the back, down the lane to an open Jackson in the corner to Powell for three. Put that one in the high. Thought that was a nice gesture on your behalf, Coach Fratello.
I didn't remember I said that.
Lob to George out of the timeout. Oh!
Very good job for San Antonio coming off the bench, giving Pop some big nights so far.
Struggled a little bit of late. Powell, his second three. Powell off the bench. 1:35 to play here in this first quarter. Back the other way. They're all the only player in double figures. Spurs out in front by that margin as well. Under a minute to play. George feeling good. Let's it fly. Wow. Currently for the Clippers. Wall into the paint. Surveys the scene. Back to George. Catch and shoot three. Oh!
So we'll see if that's the formula for this evening. 6-6, 6-6.
Lob to Leonard. Makes the grab and flushes it down. And that is a welcome sight for literally everybody, including Kawhi Leonard.
McDermott teeing up the three from
the three is short. The rebound is vacuumed in by Bassey. Quickly gets it ahead to Jones. Bates Diop down the lane in traffic and lays it in play in this first half. Clippers have led by as many as 18. Powell looks to take advantage of the big on him, and he does, and he knocks down.
Just with the ball.
Wall, top side back over to Kawhi. Powell alone in the corner, provokes a three. It's good. Norman is up for grabs. Poeltl tears it away, and here comes San Antonio.
Poeltl made Reggie change that shot, had to mark it just a little bit more than he wanted to, and then he's mind the three-point line. It's so flat coming out of his hand. He's got to get it up a little bit more.
Jackson, a catch and shoot three with the result. Grabs. Spurs did a lot of good things there, got a little lucky as well. Johnson challenging Zoo and lays it in. Tough shot. Jackson surveys the scene, launches the three, it's good. Another thing blades with Johnson, plays up top to Morris. Back to Jackson. George, the catch and shoot three. Right. Seconds on the shot clock.
Well, they like the energy that Moses Brown brings when he comes in. They're active on the glass, running the floor, and there's that little
pump fake. Baseline drive, lobs it to Moses Brown. Good defense inside there by both McDermott and Poeltl, but Brown. You want to call that a hook shot, Coach Fratello? Powell makes the grab. And Leonard. To an open Morris for three. We saw a lot of open corner threes. We talked about this the other night. Clippers have struggled in that category. Not tonight. 10 minutes to play in this third quarter. Here is Leonard. Jab step, jump shot, bucket for Kawhi Leonard. His third bucket tonight. 56 an uninspiring third quarter, really on both sides. Leonard creating space, flicks the rest, and knocks down the three.
As an old coach, is that bad of me to be selfish? One back-to-back.
Jackson Lee, see a 10 first half assists in the first half, 9 of which came in the first quarter. Bates Diop for the three, good.
30th, that's last in the league in opponent's field goal percentage and opponent's points per game.
Morris matches the goal. It's going to get very difficult as we go forward. Morris drives around the rookie, looks into the corner to man, makes the grab, flings his wrist, knocks it in. To the way, hands it off to Sohan, gives it right back to Jackson. Clippers have a power play, Wall lobs it to man. Fine, by the way, by Wall. He won't get the credit on the assist, but that was a laser. Johnson forcing the issue for three. Long shots, long rebounds, and of course, Sue's going to get it on the perimeter. Man, hit one in the other corner. Can he hit another one? Yes, sir! It has been an entertaining offensive game for the Clippers. Kawhi Leonard is out there for the fourth quarter. They lob it to him. He makes the grab and lays it in. That's 11. 15 minutes so far for Kawhi. If that's why you're wondering why he is out there, they're going to try to get him as many minutes as they can up to his restriction, which is what we're getting. Jump shot three is in and out. And Roby with a rebound for the Spurs. McDermott, catch and shoot three. It's good. Leonard. Powell splits a pair of defenders, swims with the Sharks inside and leads.
Powell with the pump fakes to get the defenders to leave their feet. They didn't leave it, but he laid it up, and here he comes in attack mode.
Backs down on McDermott, draws a crowd. Here's Reggie, sets his feet, fires a three, Reggie. Like he gets his regular entree. And Reggie leaks out. He's got a defender to beat and throws it. Greg Popovich went out of his way and just was really gushing about how much he can do. Powell, the catch and shoot three. What a pass.
If you're a defender, why would you start to rotate towards John Wall and leave Powell wide open? You want them to pass it to John Wall. Based on percentage.
It's a breather. We won't see him the rest of the night, but a job well done from him. 11 points and 4 assists. Wall foul line jumper is good for the Clippers back in that first quarter. Roby catch and shoot three. It's rebound inside. He lobs it up high. It's deflected, and Bassey comes away with it. Roby into Bassey. Feathery touch.
Right after the game is over to get him back ready for the next game.
Well, during the breaks, people at home can't see that. He's out throwing t-shirts. The Spurs at the line on any whistle going forward, so we'll have one more opportunity. Oh, Norman Powell, that's another. They are falling, and they are starting to fall for the Clippers, much the way they did for the Spurs to start the year. Nice play by Moses Brown, and Moses Brown now with 6 points in. The 100 seconds remain for the Clippers to notch their 10th win of the season. Coffee down the lane and lays it in. The Brewmaster signs his autograph. They have a chance to hold another team under 100 points here. Paul loses the ball. Branham in the corner to Barlow with 9 to shoot. Barlow fades and puts it in, likely the last bucket of the ball game. 119-97. And those that stayed stand as one as the Clippers improve to 10-7 on the year. A lot of game balls to go around, and two combatants right there, Ty Lue and Greg Popovich, 2 of 8 coaches that have won a championship. There's Kawhi Leonard going over to say hi to his former boss. And Leonard looked terrific tonight physically, was 5 of 8 from the field. And he helps the Clippers win for the 10th time, playing 22 minutes here tonight. Kawhi will likely be back at it on Monday when the Clippers host the Utah Jazz. We're hoping the same for Paul George. Right under 11. Lillard
Back inside on a drive. Hart cupped it, drives it.
Kind of getting them started from the point guard position.
Olin have looked inside for Markkanen. Now finally finds him. He'll step back. The jumper's away. Good to run. Nurkic holds out front. Here's Lillard. Stop and go. Drive. Nurkic inside. Rolls. And Quirley, one of seven, one of six from three. Lillard against Olynyk. They work the ball to the corner. It's up and good. Trying to find some. That combination, see, which Will Hardy is not afraid to do. And up and in. Conley finds one. Kessler, right place, right time. Fresh 14. Sexton has the ball stripped. Kessler picks it up and throws it home. He's trying to crawl back. Bit of a snail's pace at the moment. Here's Horton Tucker on a drive. So strong. Inside, blocked out. Nope, they deny. Back out front, Sexton. Collin, right-hand drive. He has a lane. Blocked again, Eubanks. But the follow by him right back out. Shaedon Sharpe, the rookie out of Kentucky. Never attended. Had a few practices. Beasley wants Sexton to run through. They go to Kessler. Fires it to Fontecchio for three. Bang! That's why they...
That's one of those things you just have to let go. Get to the next play, as Coach Will Hardy tells Walker Kessler.
Off the wing, the three. You can hear the net read. That opens up scoring here in the second quarter. Here's Sexton in the paint. Nice lob. Bench points here in the first half for Utah. Simon, same spot. Same spot.
That may be one time where Walker Kessler may want to show.
THT, Vanderbilt gets the back ball back to Horton Tucker. Double teamed. Out front, Beasley straight away. Oh. 37-33. But the run is 9-2 over the last minute 20 and running. Just past the 8-minute mark.
How pretty was that? Let's space it out a little bit.
Olynyk fires it off to Beasley. Steps to his left. It's away. And good.
Good looks. You can't pass those up if you're Jordan Clarkson.
Lillard drives paint. Kicks it out. The corner. And the three is Jazz. Down one. Beasley takes that three. Spins it up and hits. Will be Markkanen's fourth rebound. Inside. THT denied. There's a follow. Markkanen in one. Crowd quiet. Utah took them out of this game with that nice run. And that keeps
Lowry Markkanen posting up Damian Lillard. I was for sure he was going to take that.
Clarkson drove it into the paint. Markkanen deep. Bang! Simons off that turnover. Passes out. Markkanen showed, but not enough. Double drive, paint, floater, up and out. Too strong. Nurkic tried to save it. Jazz have it. Rotated out front. Olynyk for three.
Coming out in this third quarter, moving the ball around, finding the open guy, making the Blazers play deep.
Uh-oh. Oh. Fingertip on that shot in the corner by Grant.
Yeah, that's a great contest, great block.
THT, finger rolls it. He just blew.
I know these guys are... They're going to try to rally here and hope that their teammate Mike Conley's okay.
Vantage with the miscue. 17 points scored off the 10 turnovers. Lillard had space. Rolls it inside. The bucket drop.
The crowd on that penetration. And Nurkic, right place, right time.
17 assists on 19 made field goals for Portland. That's just a picked up. And Vanderbilt hands it off to Clarkson. With under 7.5 to play in the third. That's what Jordan does. Patient down by Olynyk.
That was almost perfect defense by everybody. He's just staying vertical.
Circus, magician, down it.
That cylinder mark. He got the tip in.
Inside. Markkanen squares up and one. Hit in 38 last night and right now has 21 on that 3-point play. Malik Beasley's knocked down 11 three-point shots.
Incredible.
Damn it! Eubanks reaches in for the rebound. I mean, it's fast and furious. Grant, three, good.
And bodies all over the place on that drive.
Eubanks runs, back on defense. Three, good now.
One and out. right? Jazz need to mix it up. Make the Blazers play some D.
Three straight threes by Portland. Take it four in a row.
A good look by the Jazz. Good ball movement.
Taken away. Sexton did not take on Eubanks. He goes to the corner.
Thrown off that time by the shot clock buzzer going off, thinking that there was a violation.
Clarkson on a run to the rack, scores it.
A lot of guys hitting the floor. Officials are letting them play a bit.
Clarkson sets his feet, good look.
Bang!
Right in front. He took the ball inside. That's now right. He works his way out. Sexton denies that inbound pass, but it did.
I like the way Coach Hardy just gives his guys confidence up here at the scores table.
Beautiful spin, Sexton, Olynyk inside the three-point line. Beautiful shot, and Nurkic passes over the top. The shot clock hits 11. They go back inside. Big fella, no. Tapped out, rebounded. Olynyk got a piece of it, but you give Clarkson 20 last night. And Utah has much improved from the free throw line at 94%. Beasley three, got it. Oda Center. This is the battle of 1 and 2 in the Western Conference. Two teams before the season began. Oh my, goes up and under.
What? Oh.
Had that gone down, I would have fallen out of the chair. Grant runs off the miss, the pass inside. And Beasley dances out front. Tried to force it to Clarkson. He takes a spill. This will be a quick run to the rack. And a bucket timeout. 105-101. Clarkson. Fronts. Now they go outside. Wing three. Workout or two. Seventh overall.
Yeah, we're down to clutch time and crunch time.
That ball pops. Blazers turning up their defensive pressure. See if the Jazz can handle it. Eubanks trails Horton Tucker, drives, and
it's the flow, but we got a good one here.
This game has taken Conley off the floor with injury in the same, oh my, with look favor of the Jazz. Out front, Clarkson. Still dribble drive. Explodes to the rack, up and down. JC with a three, and now the drive and a three-point opportunity. A one-point 134-133 win. Clarkson has been the man here. Fires up the shot. It's all Clarkson.
And he mismatch.
Backpedals. Oh. And he is barking in Portland.
Oh. Big defensive play here, Bowler.
There's a drive inside. Markkanen had two hands straight up. He lost the handle. That ball comes loose. The Jazz miss an opportunity. Josh Hart has it. Bando runs with him. 16 to play. Up and in. Josh Hart, that turnover makes it a two-point game. Will Hardy wants a timeout, and they foul Beasley.
Now, Blazers are going to have to hurry and then play the foul game.
Inside, they run it up off the rim. That's it. Markkanen cradles a rebound, and the Jazz have gone back-to-back win. Lost here to Brooklyn Thursday night on a tip-in by Royce O'Neal, and they will lose. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.